Okay, so first of all, I want to thank all the attendees. And also, I would like to thank the organizers for this opportunity and for the excellent work in organizing this conference. This is a joint work with Ana Dias from Porto. So I will consider wake the networks where the connections between the nodes have wakes and they represent the strength of connections. So associated to a network, I will consider the adjacency matrix with rows and columns indexed by the nodes of the network, where for each row indicates for each node what are the wakes of the connections that it receives from the other nodes. And if it is zero, it means that there is no connection. The Laplacian matrix is obtained from the adjacency matrix in this way, where this DG matrix is a diagonal matrix, where in the diagonals we have the row sums of the adjacency matrix. So we will associate to each network a class of dynamical systems. We consider ordinary differential equations. So each node is an individual dynamical system, and the couplings between the nodes, between the cells, indicate the influential dynamical from one node to the others. In this work, we consider that the cells are all of the same type, which means that they have the same phase space and they have the same internal dynamics. For this particular case of the wake networks, we consider that the couple cell systems have an additive input structure, which is very common in applications. So the equation for cell J has a function that is the internal dynamics of the cell plus some coupling functions that are according to the connections that the cell J receives. And this wake is the wake of the connection of the adjacency matrix. So the systems of the form for a network G are said admissible, and we consider the set of the input admissible couple cell systems by a network G. So in this example, looking to the equation of cell one, we see that it has the internal dynamics, and then for each of the connections, there is an additive term of the coupling function multiplied by the corresponding wake. Okay. Now let's concentrate on the equations of cells two and three, and we see that if we start with an initial condition where the initial condition for the cells two and three is the same, then the equations will be the same, and then the trajectory will evolve in the same way. So when this happens, we say that the subspace of the total phase space given by defined by this equality x2 equal x3 is a synchrony subspace for the class of the admissible couple cell systems. So we say that two cells are in synchrony if their dynamics coincide for all time, and we define a polydiagonal subspace as a subspace of total phase space that is defined by equalities of cell coordinates. So, giving the set of the cells of the network, if we consider a partition, a set of parts that whose union is the set of the cells, then to each partition we associate a polydiagonal subspace where it is defined in this way. It has equality xi equal xj if I and j are in the same part. So for example, if we have a couple cell network with 8 cells, and we have this partition of the cells, then to this partition we associate this polydiagonal subspace. You see that one of the parts contains cells 1, 3, and 8, so in the polydiagonal subspace we have this condition, and so on. So given a set of couple cell systems that are admissible by the network, we say that the polydiagonal subspace is a synchronous subspace for that set of systems if it is left invariant by all the systems in that set. Flow invariant subspaces, of course, they are very important because they have a major impact on both global and local dynamics in its bifurcations. And for example, they allow the existence of robust heteroclinic cycles. They are also important from the point of view of the study of dynamics, because if we have a flow invariant subspace, then we can restrict to the dynamics to that subspace, which is lower dimensional, and then we get a lower dimensional dynamical system, which is easier to study. So synchrony subspaces are a particular type of invariant subspaces that are common in applications, and synchrony is a very important phenomenon from the point of view of the applications. And an important fact is that the synchrony subspaces can be present even if there are no symmetries. Of course, we know that systems have symmetries, they have flow invariant subspaces, the fixed point subspaces, but in the context of couple cell networks, we can have synchrony subspaces, flow invariant subspaces that are not forced by the symmetry and are only forced by the network structure. So, to illustrate the importance of reduction, we consider again the same example. We have seen that X2 equal X3 is a synchrony subspace. So, what we can do? We can reduce to this system by where we eliminating the equation for cell free, so we get a new system with only three cells corresponding to this couple cell network, and so this system will be easier to study. And all the dynamics we get for these systems, we know that we have that dynamics in this system in the, for the subspace X2 equal X3. Okay, keeping with the same example, we also observe that this polydiagonal subspace is also a synchrony subspace because it is flow invariant. Looking to the equations, we see that if x1 equal x2 is x3, then the equations will be equal. This one will sum to this one, and we get is equal to this part, and then this part will be equal to this part. Now the question is, how can we characterize the synchrony subspaces given a network? And the result is that a polydiagonal subspace is a synchrony subspace for the admissible couple systems that are input additive, if and only if the partition that is associated is balanced. And what does that mean? That means that the polydiagonal subspace associated to the partition, considering the subspace the space Rn, is left invariant by the adjacency matrix of the network. Okay, so we consider the set of all the balanced partitions denoted by this. Returning to the example, we will now consider the polydiagonal X2 equal X3 equal X4. And in this case, we come to the conclusion that it is not a synchrony subspace because these three equations will not be equal. this part will be equal, but this part will not be equal because of this value here, okay? But if we assume one restriction in the coupling function, if we restrict to the coupling functions that satisfy this condition, and we have another set of coupled systems that is a subset of the initial one, and then in this case, this part will be zero, and then the equations will be equal. So for this set of systems, this polydiagonal is a synchronous subspace. Okay, so we have another result. A polydiagonal subspace is a synchronous subspace for this set of coupled systems if and only if the partition is exobalance. And what does that mean? That means that the polydiagonal subspace in Rn is left invariant by the Laplacian matrix. Okay, so we consider the set of the exobalance partitions, and we have that the set of the balance partitions, the last one, is a subset of this one. Okay, but in the case where the network is regular, which means that the sum of the rows of the adjacency matrix is equal to all rows, then these two sets are the same. So the balance and the exobalance partitions are the same. Now we consider antisynchrony. So in an antisynchrony subspace, besides equalities of cell coordinates that we were considering, we will consider also that we have cell coordinates with the same magnitude, but opposite sign, and we can also have cell coordinates that are zero. Okay, so antisynchronization is also observed in different scenarios, for example, in coupled oscillators. So we will consider a more general definition of partition, so that we call a tagged partition, because we'll consider different parts. We have these P parts, and then these parts with an over bar, we call it the counterparts of these parts, and then we have a special part that is the zero part. So having a tagged partition, we associate a generalized polydiagonal subspace in this way. So if J is in the same part of I, then we have Xj equal Xi. If J is in the counterpart of I, then Xj is equal minus Xi, and for the cells that are in the zero part, Xj is equal to zero, okay? So the standard, the partitions that we were considering, they have only these parts, so they have no counterparts and no zero part, and so the what we call a polydiagonal subspace have only conditions of this form. I don't have these two kinds of conditions. An antisynchrony subspace for a set of coupled systems is a generalized polydiagonal subspace associated with a non-star standard partition that is left invariant under the flow of every system in that set. So returning to the example, we consider this generalized polydiagonal subspace with this condition x1 is equal minus x2 equal minus x3 and x4 equals zero. So this is not a synchronous subspace for the whole class of the input additive coupled cell systems, because substituting in the equations, here we get G of X1, here we get G of minus X1, this part is not equal to this part, so this is not left invariant under the flow of all the systems. But if we restrict the class of systems that we are considering, so if we consider systems such that the internal dynamics, the function is odd, and the coupling function is heaven in X and odd in Y, then this will be an anti-synchronous subspace for this class of systems, okay? Because since G is odd, this minus can come outside. Here H is odd in X, so this minus disappears, and it is odd in Y, so this minus come outside. So the equations become the same, and this equation becomes zero because G is odd, so G of zero is zero, and these two will cancel, okay? We have this result. Polydiagonal subspace is an anti-synchronous subspace for this class of systems, if and only if the associated partition is even odd balance. And what does it mean? It means that the polydiagonal, the associated polydiagonal of Rn is left invariant by the adjacency matrix. Okay. So then we have another class of set of systems. In this case, the condition is that G is odd and H is linear for the systems in this set. And in this case, we have that a generalized polydiagonal is anti-synchronous subspace if the partition is linear balance, which means that the generalized polydiagonal of Rn is left invariant by the Laplacian matrix. So these are the linear balance partitions. So the exovalence partitions that we have seen before is not a subset of the linear, neither the linear is a subset of the exovalence in general, but if G is a regular network, then they will coincide. So when we have a tagged partition, we can renumber the cells such that the adjacency and Laplacian matrix have this block structure. So here we have, in this part, we have the connections from the cells in the parts Pj, Pj over bar and P0 to the parts Pi. Then this part is for the over bar, and this part is for the P0 part. So we have results that characterize, give conditions on these blocks such that the partition is balanced, exovalence, linear balance. But here I just want to introduce another type of partition that we define, that is the odd balance partition. And a partition is odd balance if the blocks satisfy certain conditions, if these blocks are regular, and if pairs of blocks have the same sum, row sum, okay? So all the blocks except the ones in the diagonal must be regular, have the same sum for all rows. And then, for example, this block has to have the same row sum as this one, and this one, and this one. So we have certain conditions, okay? This define an odd balance partition. And this odd balance partition is a subset of the linear partitions. In general, these subsets are different. And so we define another class, another set of coupled systems. In this case, where the internal function and the coupling function are odd, and so we have the result that an anti-generalized polydiagonal subspace is an anti-synchronous subspace for this set of systems if and only if the partition is odd balanced. Okay, so resuming, we have considered these sets of systems, the ones, this is the more general, so this, all the systems that are input additive and admissible by the network, and then we have considered subsets of this set by imposing restrictions either in the internal function, either in the coupling function. And so these sets have these inclusions. And what we have proved is that if we consider the set of the generalized polydiagonal subspaces invariant by the adjacency matrix and the set of generalized polydiagonal subspaces invariant by the Laplacian, then the union of these sets gives us the synchrony and anti-synchrony subspaces for the network. And we know that if a polydiagonal in that set is a synchronous subspace for this set of systems, or for this one, if and only if the partition is balanced. It is a synchronous subspace for this set of systems, and so for these ones, if and only if it is exobalanced. A polydiagonal subspace, a generalized polydiagonal subspace, is an anti-synchronous subspace for this system if it is odd balance, for this set of systems if it is linear balance, and for this one if it is odd balance. Okay, so let's see an example. So now we have the question how we can get all these polydiagonal subspaces that are invariant by these two matrices. In this case, so if the network is regular, these two sets are equal, so we just need to compute one. In this case, it is not regular because row 1, the sum is 2, row 2 is 2, but this the row sum is 1, so it is not regular, so they are different. So we'll start to, sorry, I'm not listening. Okay. So to compute these subspaces, we use the eigenspaces of the network. So if we could consider the adjacency matrix, we start by calculating the eigenspaces, then we find the polydiagonals that are associated to the eigenvectors. So for each eigenvector, we calculate the small polydiagonal that contains it. Then we have to see if these polydiagonals are synchronous subspaces, which means that they are flow invariant, which means that they have an eigenvector basis. If so, then these polydiagonals will be a sum dense set for the lattice of the subspace of the synchronous subspaces for the network for this lattice, and then we obtain the remaining subspaces by considering all the possible sums between these subspaces and not all of them will be synchronous subspaces. We have to check if they are invariant by the matrix. Okay, so in this case we have this. Then we do the same for the Laplacian matrix. And so, okay.
Could you come to an end, please? Because we are running short of time.
Okay. So let me just finish with this. So this starts with these formalisms of Lugalevitsky, Stewart, and Torek, and Field. So we have this last part of the example I was showing how to obtain the lattice is done is this work, then we generalize to the work, the previous work in this formalism is not for WAG networks. In this work, it's generalized for WAG networks. The motivation for this work is this one, where they consider different couple vector fields. And here in this work, it's generalized for WAG networks. Okay, so I will end.